Hi, for this video what I want to do is talk to you about circular functions in the unit circle. They're also known as trigonometric functions. These are the functions that will be used a lot when referencing the unit circle, and they are very important concepts to understand. Okay, so what we have here is a picture of the unit circle. The unit circle is basically just the equation of the circle x squared plus y squared equals 1, where the center is at the origin and the radius is 1. So whenever we're referencing the unit circle, this is the relationship where it's drawn in the coordinate plane. So it's going to be centered at the origin 0, 0. And then we're going to start at the point 1, 0. So what we're going to be talking about is any single point on the unit circle is a coordinate. So we could use x, y as any point on the circle. Okay, and what we're going to be talking about is we're going to be talking about the arc length that's intercepted in this circle. So I'm going to use yellow for that. So let's say that our point is here at x, y. So our arc length that we're talking about, basically this is just our measurement of our radians. So this is going to be S, our arc length. Okay, when we rotate in the unit circle, if we're rotating positive, if we have a positive angle, that means that we're going to rotate counterclockwise. If we have a negative angle, that means that we're going to rotate clockwise. A lot of times we will use theta to represent this angle of opening in here, and I should have drawn my picture a little bit bigger, but that's okay. Okay, so basically what's happening in here, and the reason that these circular functions, they're called the circular functions, is because we're referencing the unit circle, and the reason they're known as trigonometric functions is because these are the relationships that we see in right triangles. So basically any point in this circle, we could draw a right triangle to reference that point. So I'm just going to draw a picture down here that's a little bit bigger. So basically what's happening is we always have a right triangle that can be drawn to any point on the circle. Okay, where theta represents the angle of measurement that we're talking about down here. So if we're talking about this point right here being at the origin, okay, then my x comma y point, we can see that x is this distance right here, and y is this distance here. And in the unit circle, our radius is 1. So if you remember from geometry that sine is always equal to the opposite over the hypotenuse, and I always learned this as SOHCAHTOA, okay, cosine is always the adjacent, which means the side next to but not the hypotenuse, over the hypotenuse. And tangent equals the opposite over the adjacent. Okay, so if we look at this here in reference to our right triangle, it's easy to see that if I take this angle here and I'm trying to find sine, sine is going to be the opposite side over the hypotenuse. So if you look at this right here, the opposite is y, the hypotenuse is 1, so we could say that this is y over 1, which is just y. Okay, cosine is the adjacent, which means the side next to that angle that is formed between the x-axis and wherever the radius of the stopping point is. Okay, so that's my adjacent, which is x, over the hypotenuse, which is 1. Okay, and then the tangent of that is always opposite, which is y, over adjacent, which is x. Okay, so that's where all these circular functions come from, and they're also known as the trigonometric functions because we're dealing with sine, cosine, and tangent. So I've already written this all out for you in the way that you would see it in a textbook. I just kind of wanted to explain where this was coming from. I know my picture wasn't large enough to be able to really show it in there. Okay, so what we have is if xy is a point on the unit circle that corresponds to a real number s, which is known as the arc length, so this is our radians, then the following are always going to be true. So this is a relationship that you want to understand. And this is the relationship that we built down here to help us see this visually where we got the y and the x from. But this is something that you want to know. The sine of any arc length is always equal to the y coordinate. The cosine is always the x coordinate. So if you want to think about it as far as the ordered pair goes, you can always write it as cosine, comma, sine. So x is always the cosine, y is always the sine. And then tangent is opposite over adjacent, so that's the y over x. These functions in blue right here are known as the reciprocal functions. The reciprocal functions are cosecant, secant, and cotangent. And I basically wrote them next to each other. So sine and cosecant are reciprocal functions. So reciprocal just means to switch the coordinates. Like if I basically flip this around, instead of being y, it's going to be 1 over y. Cosine and secant are reciprocal functions. So x becomes 1 over x for the secant. And then cotangent and tangent are reciprocal functions. So I'm just flipping my fraction to x over y. Remember that the denominator can never equal 0. So for sine and cosine, the domain for these is any real number. Any number can be plugged in there for s. The tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent are undefined at some places. Okay, they are undefined for tangent and for secant whenever x is equal to 0, they are undefined. And for cotangent and cosecant, they are undefined when y is equal to 0, because I cannot do 1 divided by 0. So I will do some other videos that address how to find the coordinates or how to find sine based on the unit circle, but it's important to understand, especially the sine and the cosine, that cosine is always x and sine is y. As always, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please let me know. If there are additional topics you need me to cover, please let me know that as well.